Dr. Jacob and Anu.
Sorry, I'm so used to having you.
Why this is important, why is prevention important? If we could prevent, then can you imagine? You didn't have to go through the whole cleaning up. Like Karishma said, if you saw that hole right in the beginning and didn't fall into it, then maybe you would not be hurt. So the question that came to my mind and why I have invited Dr. Jacob, he's not my doctor, he's just somebody who analyzed my body about 4 days back. And the reason I called him to this conference is because he has something amazing to offer, and I think all of you should make use of it. The reason that I'm standing with him is because I have something amazing to offer and we are not in competition. Yet, why is it that I'm introducing him? The question is, do we know ourselves completely? What if you couldn't talk about your conflicts? How will you express? How will you tell someone what's going on? What if you were deaf, dumb, blind, and you couldn't see and you couldn't tell anyone? I'm talking about people who cannot express for whatever reason. Most of our therapies are around the information that we get from the person. By him talking, it's all auditory. And we are then looking at the visual clues and getting into the feeling and trying to deal with it. How are you going to do a therapy for a person who cannot hear? So how are you going to, let's say Amy, Doreen's little baby is crying. How will you know that something is wrong with her? So that is where Anu Mehta and Dr. Jacob come in. So Dr. Jacob, if you can please tell people about your device, because it's amazing. I would have never known if I had not come on that day
that
I don't have a heart problem anymore.
Yes, that's good.
That's very good.
Yes.
But I do have another problem to tackle,
yes,
which may be that I'm heading for insulin resistance.
Yes.
And I'm taking it very seriously. Thank you.
That's good.
Yes.
Ignorance is not a bliss. You know that one very clearly. And see, even we heard that just shared about the to know about your body. And many times we don't know about that. See, when we are doing the screening, I noticed that one, see how we can get a lot of information. And what is happening in our body, that is more important. And then we can work according into that one. See, most of the problems are, we can say, lifestyle issues. And the stress is coming, we know that one, and metaphysics especially is dealing, meta health is dealing with that one, the emotions which are coming, but emotions, how it is reflecting in the body. How will you know that one? Whether it is still continuing or not. And we have no idea. For example, when I was checking yesterday, and some of the people still have diabetics. Diabetes is still not the control. They're taking the medicine. Whether the medicine is effective or not, how will we know that? So that's more important. And if you know that the medicine is not working on our body, or the treatment or therapy is not working on the body, surely we can change it. If you are not understanding that one, then we cannot. One of the cases which I wanted to share with you is one of the diabetic person who came to me, and he told me that, Doctor, I am taking medicine and it is continuing. I have no issue at all. Then I screened him and I told him, your diabetes is not at all controlled. You have to go and take an HbA1c as well as a fasting sugar for me. So he went and he took the report, blood report, and the report came as 11 HbA1c. So very highly diabetic. And he is continuing with the medicine. Why he is continuing with the medicine? Once long back he got the prescription. And we, one of the thing which we have in our mind is, we don't want to see the doctors. There is a problem with the people. We don't want to see the doctors. And once we got the prescription, we'll take the prescription, and throughout our life, we will continue with that prescription. We'll think that, yes, that is a problem. Or sometimes something similar to that one happened to somebody. We'll think that one, else, that medicine is sufficient for me. So we will self-treat ourselves on that one. So that is not right. And we have to analyze our health so that we can live a better life and a healthy and a better life. So that's why I came into the picture, and I screened more than 10,000 people. And I observe many areas, even though which we can't understand. That means by other analysis we cannot understand. We can detect from this one. Especially we are checking the vertebrae as well as the neural network, the nervous system. So vertebrae and the nervous system is very clearly sharing that if you have a heart issue, we can tell that the blockage is developing, or even the cholesterol is starting, or if there is any problem in the heart, it will reflect there. And once you cleared that one, I observe that one, yes, that is going. So that is cleared. Like the chakra healing. The same thing, it is also getting healed, and we can notice that one. Yes,
he also talks about nutrition in the same scan. And in the nutrition, he actually tells you what are the foods that are not suiting you. So this is just one way of doing it, right?
Yes. I want to explain a little bit on that. When we are eating, and our eating habits is the same thing. If you are eating banana every day, we will eat banana and it will continue, and we will not stop that one. So the chemical composition of our body is changing. Just now, I screened one person, and he is eating, we can say, eggplant, otherwise called brinjal. So he likes that every day, and he is taking that one. And when the report came, and it is clearly mentioned that he has to avoid brinjal, so eggplant. So that shows that, you see, what he is eating, the chemical composition is changing. And what we have to eat and what we should not eat, that is more important. Many times I observe the people, those who are eating gluten-based food, is creating a problem in their stomach. And especially in the large intestine, and they are getting issues with that one. Gluten is allergic to many groups of people, and we know that doctors are advising that oats are very good. We will take oats and continue with the oats, and with different varieties we will go and we will continue that one. But oats is a gluten-based food, and if you are not recognizing that one, surely that is a problem. So change the food habits, change the lifestyle. And on the preventive side, I want to share one more thing. Preventive side, and I was also listening a lot throughout the sessions. I was so interesting, and I observe four things which is mainly required, which I am teaching to the people. One is drinking lot of water. Very good.
That was a suggestion he gave me, drink a lot of water.
Yes. It is good for detoxification. It is good for our body. And energetic, if you are getting that one, that is very good. The second one is deep breathing, oxygen. The all practices what we are doing here is deep breathing. If you deep breathe, that will help our body. And the third is a little more walking exercise, aerobic exercise. I will suggest that 20 to 40 minutes per day is required. And the last fourth, I think Stefan is the person. He mentioned that one, you have to get sunlight.
Very good.
And 10 minutes sunlight is sufficient for your body to produce enough vitamin D. And if you are getting vitamin D, your absorption will be proper. All other vitamins will be absorbed in the body. Your calcium level will be normal. But we are ignoring all this one, and we are going and running around. So getting a knowledge about your body, how is my body composition? If I require some vitamins more, or some vitamins are, I don't require anything, we can analyze that one. What type of food you can eat and what type of food you have to avoid. Whether any complications. Again, I wanted to share one screening I did in the afternoon, and the report showed excellent. No problem for him, no heart issues, no chances of getting any illness for him for the next 10 years, and no diabetes, no cholesterol, nothing, and he is 41 years old. The good thing is, he immediately shared to another person, and they also did this one, screening. See, when you feel better, I'm telling that you will be more energetic. And the energy will grow and you will also be communicate to other people in the same level. You will feel that one, yes, the energy is good in my body, then the productivity is also increasing. When the productivity is increasing, surely you can give a lot more to the universe.
I will add to it over here. He told me that the iron tablets that I've been taking for the last 1 year have made my blood excess in the body, and that could be the cause of many, many problems. So I actually did stop my iron tablets and did stop a lot of things from what he did suggest. So thank you so much.
Thank you so much. As I mentioned yesterday, that the screening is there. You can get a golden opportunity here again for 2 more days. That is on this
He's
tomorrow,
right
Saturday,
there, right
Saturday
back, and you
and
can
Sunday,
get your scans
and
done.
After this also, even up to 9:30 we can do. And don't miss this one. There is an energy exchange is also very nominal. That's what I mentioned. Because we are charging $250, but here it's only $100.
Right.
Thank you
so much.
I
will continue for the next 5 minutes and stop this. Is that okay with all of you? Tired, very tired. Very good. Thank you so much. I really appreciate your assistance and support. Thank you. So what happens with a small child? So I give you a fast case study with the software that I have. It is called the Provision Scan. It's a scanning machine. You just have to put your hand on the little mouse, like I showed you in the afternoon, and the whole body gets scanned. Now, I'm sure Rob said something really interesting, Rob Van Overbruggen, that the body is never consistent. Now, if the body is not consistent, that can be seen in this provision scan, that body is not consistent. If I did 5 scans of yours, back to back, each one will be different. Yes, each one will be different. Then what is consistent? I will take the similar factors and look at it and say what's happening. But what is interesting in this scan, if a little baby comes to me, a 2-day-old baby, I cannot put that 2-day-old baby probably on your machine. Can I? Thank you. Thank you. But I can put my device on a 2-day-old baby and be at work. The 2-day-old baby that had come had got blisters all over here, all over the back as well as the genitals. And we did the screening of the baby and we realized the baby was very, 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 very angry. 2-day-old baby. Her legs were crooked. She had immense pain and she was screaming and really crying. Doctors had told that she would be in the ICU, intensive care unit, for the next few days. Parents were from underprivileged strata and they didn't know what to do. Now, looking at a 2-day-old baby, we could really find out what's really required. Here I need to acknowledge Rose Heyman, who is not in this world anymore, from Australia, who was with me at that time, and we worked together, a lot of learning. We took coconut water, we immersed the muslin cloth in that, and she wrapped it around the genitals so that the baby doesn't have pain. Along with that, we gave infraceuticals, the gel water that Stefan was talking about. It's inflammation water, and the baby started recouping. Within the next 1 week, baby did not have any rash. We worked with a device called My Health after that, and the baby's legs, which were crooked, became straight. She had to be, only one leg had to be plastered for some time, but what was more important was to get the scan of the mother as well as the father. When we did the scanning for the mother and father, we realized that the mother was carrying the same anger that the child was carrying. On questioning, we kept the whole family and asked, what is happening in your life? Why is the child so angry? Why is the mother so angry? So the story unraveled. 6 months when she was pregnant. In India, it's very important to be a male child. For many, many, many. They want the baby boy, they don't want a baby girl. And the father-in-law of the lady said, I want a baby boy, but there was a ceremony that was performed, a simple ceremony, and the lady picked up a sweetmeat to eat. And from that, they kind of analyzed and said, oh, she's going to have a baby girl. They didn't even have a sonography. But they started ill-treating the mom to that extent. They were beating her up. They were doing stuff to her which wasn't okay. And the baby didn't want to be a girl anymore. That's why there was so much, the skin on that area was completely peeling off the minute she was born. So we had to actually sit down and tell the whole family, the kid will not survive if you all don't put things together. Today the parents have separated, but the baby is walking, she's running, and she has no problems. But sadly enough, the family has got. Thank you so much for listening. I really, 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 really appreciate, and I'm sorry to be late.